The scrimmage was better. I would say, again, just because we went up and down yesterday, more intense. We did more defense today. But, the thing I like so far is there's been good carryover from the things that we've worked on, like in the practice part, into the scrimmage part, which is, shows that, our heads are in the right place. And I think we're focused on just getting organized and making progress.
When you say that, Al mentioned to us yesterday that he was really impressed by how quickly the new guys seem to be picking everything up. And when we asked him what, he said, we ran dummy offense, and he said a lot of times that just looks chaotic the first day, and it wasn't anything like that.
No, you know what? The guys that are under contract, and then also the guys that are here like as free agents trying to make the team, they've run really good too organizationally, which is critical because it only takes, when you only have five guys out there, if one guy can't execute or get to his spot, it screws up to how quickly the team can go forward. So, no, both days they really did a good job with that, both days.
Is there anything else you'd like to get out of Al that you haven't already seen?
I'd certainly take the way he played last year.
Yeah, I know.
But the thing I like about him is that he's working hard. Like when I met with him about it, his big thing was he wants to be better on his high pick and roll defense. Mm-hmm. So I think that his whole attitude is great. I sense more of a hunger to have a year similar to last year more than I do any complacency or anything like that. And I do know he sees that, what the possibilities are, I think, for the group, and he's competitive and he wants to win.
What were some of the things that you worked on this summer?
I worked on my jump shot, worked on defense, and just keep my body in great condition.
Do you feel like sometimes your antics off on the court and your attitude kind of overshadows your talent at all?
Sometimes it does. That's why I'm going to cut it down this year, and I'll just stay focused on just playing regular basketball and winning.
Do you see this being a breakout season for you?
I have a lot of goals. I just want to just play hard and help this team win.
Mm-hmm. Are you feeling more comfortable on one side of the court or the other as you get into these scrimmages?
With the Pacers, I was always on the right side of the court. But Coach Clifford wanted me to be able to do both sides. So I got to get used to that and just adjust to that and learn Hornets basketball.
Anything else you're adjusting to system-wise with this particular team?
Just a lot of movement. You move a lot, you got to be in great shape to be on this team. So I got to get in a little bit more shape and just learn how to score off these plays.
You're coming from a winning team from Indiana. Do you feel like the Hornets still have something to prove this season?
Definitely. I came at the right time when they changed the name and we got new players and I feel like a new beginning. So this year, we just got to come off at a good start and win.
You feeling comfortable with anyone in particular, getting catch and shoots or anything like that? You developing a rhythm with anyone?
Everybody's all about team and winning. So, these group of guys are great hearted and just want to win. So when you got a team like that, and we also unselfish. So when you got a team like that, the game come easy for everyone.
It's day two now in camp. Is it getting physical? Is it getting chippy or anything like that? Or are they just competing hard?
Camp is always physical. We gotta get our physical side, get everybody tough, and getting ready for the big boys because this is a great league.
You looking forward to preseason? First game, October 8th?
Oh, definitely. Ready.
Well, I'm going to switch it up to something a little bit more fun. So I know you did a remix to Bobby Schmurder's Hot and Word. What are your music goals?
Just starting to come out with a lot of songs. I got a lot of songs to come out with, but I'm going to just focus on the season.
So
right
do you
now.
Put music on the back burner during the season and you go back to music?
Yeah. That's like a summer thing. So yeah. I'm going to come out with a lot of songs during the summer. Right now, I got to get focused and adjusted to this team and start winning. I don't want my music or anything to take a conflict with the team.
So do you consider yourself a battle rapper or a lyricist?
Just having fun with it. Shaq had fun with it. I just want to do something like how he did. Yeah. Probably come out with an album one day. But right now,
yeah,
Basketball.
Well, okay, this is the last one now. This is for all the viewers that are going to be watching this. You gonna bust a flow out or something right now? A couple 16? Nothing? You sure?
Yeah, because okay. I don't want to say any words.
You don't want to take the shot with nobody? I like the hot remix, though. Yeah. I liked it. Thank I downloaded you. It, just letting you know.
Thank you.
Well, good luck this season. All right.
Obviously, everybody knows how to do it. Cavs All-NBA last year. I felt like he should have been an All-Star last year. I got a chance to play with him in Utah, playing with him growing up. He's a special player, man. The thing I like most about him is the person. You know, who he is as a person, as an individual. You know, it's a special feeling to kind of be a part of something.
He was the first really big free agent to take a chance here in Charlotte, come in and say, hey, I might not be going to one of the larger markets. I'm going to come here and try and make a difference with this team. When you came on board, what did he tell you about this franchise and why it was a result?
Well, first and foremost, he spoke very highly of Coach. You know, that was really exciting. You know, he had nothing but great things to say about Coach. He wasn't the only person. Mm-hmm. You know, so to hear, you know, players speak so highly of a coach, they want to play for a coach, you know, that was really exciting for me. And, you know, just being around Coach for the last month or so, I know exactly what they're talking about. So that was really exciting to me. So I spoke with him, I spoke to Fargo. You know, everything they told me, man, was very true.
You know, when you look at Al's game, does anybody have more pump fakes in his repertoire than Mac Dak?
No, I don't think so. You know, it's funny, man. We joke around, you know, because he's so great with his right hand. So we try to get him to shoot one or two shots a day with his left hand. So he usually gives us one shot a day with his left hand early in practice, and then we just kind of leave him alone. But he's a hell of a player, man. I'm glad to be a teammate there.
You're known
as
one of the most jump shots. Do you feel like you've been able to fix that?
I think it's coming along.
Some of the things that you did during the summer to work on?
I'll fix everything, basically.
What do you see your role being this year?
Just to play defense, of course. And then offense and just hoop.
Do you feel a lot of defensive pressure on you because you are one of like the best defenders on the team?
I don't think so. I'm just having fun.
Do you feel like you're out here fighting for a starting spot? Do you feel like pressure or anything?
I don't feel no pressure at all. I'm just learning every day.